Laws to prosecute drivers who use their mobile phones are to be strengthened across the UK. At the moment, motorists are banned only from texting or making calls. But from next year, it will also be illegal to take photos, play games, or scroll through playlists while driving. Well, joining us now is Nick Freeman, author, commentator, and criminal defence lawyer known as Mr. Loophole. I'm not sure if you like being called Mr. Loophole, do you?
It was the media that called it me, so I didn't really have much choice about it. And I embraced it and trademarked it, actually. So I suppose you'd say I do like it now. Yes, thank you.
Maybe I'll call you Mr. Freeman. Look, it's worth explaining, I think, a bit more to our viewers exactly how the current law works, first of all.
Well, the current law, in relation to a specific piece of legislation, the Crown have to prove beyond reasonable doubt that the defendant was using the phone handheld for an interactive communication. So there are a whole host of activities. For example, the well-known case of Jimmy Carr in 2009, he was recording a joke. That wasn't an interactive communication and that didn't infringe this specific legislation. So the intention back in 2003, when this legislation was initially introduced, was to stop people using phones. But of course, phones have become much more sophisticated and they're now used for a whole plethora of different things. And people have a very cavalier disregard, really, to the law because there are very few police about. So what the government is saying is any form of use of a handheld phone is going to be outlawed and it will have 6 points and there will be a financial penalty attached to that. That's because it's proving too hard to prove this interactive communication. The reason for that is there are too few police on the streets and unless you get an admission from somebody or you actually record a conversation, it's hard. It's a high burden for the Crown to prove, and they're failing on many occasions. So that's the difficulty. So this legislation is going to outlaw all types of handheld use, irrespective of the purpose. So if you're using your phone for anything, whether it be interactive or not, you will fall foul of this specific legislation. But I do think it's important just to bear in mind, you know, we want to be careful about using our phone for any purpose. We don't want to labour under the misapprehension that if you use your phone hands-free at the moment, that's all right. Because even using your phone hands-free, the level of distraction is the same as drink driving. And what happens is occasionally people are involved in an accident because they're using the phone in what they perceive to be a legal basis. And they then have the full force of law upon them and they face very heavy consequences. So the public, I think, are being slightly misled at the moment, not intentionally, because they think, well, I'm using my phone, I'm using my sat-nav, that's perfectly permissible. It is, so long as there isn't an incident. If there is an incident, the level of distraction will result in serious criminal charges, dependent, of course, upon the consequences of your driving. So the idea of this is to make it much easier for prosecutors. Yeah. In my view, because there's too few police on our roads, we need an increase in the sentence. Yeah. I think 6 points is not enough, and I think we need a sentence that polices itself, and there should be parity between drink driving and using a mobile phone. A 12-month minimum mandatory disqualification, I think that will police the problem, and that will be the extra piece of the jigsaw that the government might consider putting in place to make our roads much safer.
Nick Freeman, we must leave it there, but good to talk to you. Thank you.
Thank you very much.